Hello and welcome. What you are about to see is unlike anything you have ever seen before. Today, two lucky singles will be going on an exclusive blind date.
We're talking about cable cars, sightseeing,
and romance in hopes that these two singles will become a happy couple. But there is one catch.
One.
These two singles will not be driving themselves. Instead, they will be escorted by a brand new stretch limo. Guys, this is like prom 2.0. Except here, we have a different name for it. That name is
O-Limo-Date.
What's up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
What's up?
It doesn't matter what you do, who you are, what you look like, I have to just click. And then it's very immediate. I know it within the first 5 minutes.
Any guy who can take me out to a restaurant I haven't been to before, introduce me to new food, huge turn on.
Drinks, I like whiskey and bourbon and I love tequila, but I'm very careful about it.
I might make him laugh more. He'd be like, shut up.
Okay, okay. What's up?
What's up?
Yeah, come on.
What's up?
Okay.
Welcome to O-Limo-Date, where you can find your mate, and you can ride in a limousine and see your face on reality TV. O-Limo-Date.
We're supposed to shoot.
What?
The limo date.
What? Oh man. She here?
Hi, welcome to the behind the scene of O-Limo-Date. This is Ben Darko, one of the producers of the show. This is a new reality TV show where we pair people going to blind date. We give them a limo. They go out there, they go to a fancy restaurant like this one. This is called the Mona Lisa, and it's an Italian restaurant. It's got everything you need. It doesn't matter your sexual orientation, whether, you know, it doesn't matter. So long you need somebody, we're gonna pair you up with that somebody. So check out O-Limo-Date San Francisco. Same thing is gonna happen to other cities. We're gonna go to LA and do O-Limo-Date LA, O-Limo-Date New York, O-Limo-Date Miami. We're gonna go out there and find really, really nice restaurants like this one and just set up people, order whatever they want, give them a good scenario, and at the end of the show, it's up to you whether you wanna, you felt you connected with your date or not. Man, I'm telling you, the wine is good, the food is good, and if you don't close the deal at the end of the night, I don't know. That's O-Limo-Date behind the scenes. I got the other producer, Darren Gates, and also we're gonna let you see the owner of the restaurant. His name is Mauricio for this particular spot, Mona Lisa.
I opened the place in 1994, and I serve the best Italian food, the original homemade pasta, organic tomato, real, real Italian. I like to serve everybody, my friend. This is a restaurant, my restaurant, the family.
Oh! and I'm here at Mona Lisa Restaurant in San Francisco, and I'm here with director of O-Limo-Date, Darren Getz. Darren, could you tell us a little bit about the show?
Yeah, I'd love to. Actually, the show was created with me and my partner, who's also a producer on the show. She's actually in there hanging out with the owner for the restaurant, Mona Lisa's. Really great place for Italian food. But we were actually working on a documentary, and we were in one of the limos for the documentary, and we came up with this awesome idea to have a reality TV show called O-Limo-Date.
Okay, so just wondering, like, with this whole matchmaking thing, who does the matchmaking for this program? I mean, who's in charge of setting these people up?
Actually, how it works is we have this top-of-the-line computer system. And it's really sophisticated, and what it does is it analyzes everyone from their personality all the way down to the things they like, all the way to you name it, and it just, 99% of the time, it's almost perfectly right and it finds that perfect match.
Wow, so I mean, the perfect match is not always the most exciting thing in the world. I mean, some people want to see a little bit of drama and a little bit of excitement in the show. I mean, do you have anything planned? Anything planned for excitement or?
Well, yeah. Actually, how it works is we pair someone up on a blind date, but we don't just send them on one blind date. We actually send them on two. And some of our matchmakers on our show told us that they're sometimes going to actually hit the wrong button and set them up with the complete opposite. So you're probably going to have a lot of drama on the show.
Okay, I see. Well, that sounds awesome. So when is the show planning on coming out? Like, do you have any plans for the exact date of when the show is going to be airing?
We're actually in the process of filming it now as we speak. Here we are. Hey, hello everyone.
Well, since you said that, I guess I better cancel my plans for the next couple months because I'm going to be at work.
Yeah.
I didn't know we were going to be airing in January, but that sounds awesome. That sounds great. I'm really looking forward to it and looking forward to working with you, and it's going to be an exciting show.
There's also another major twist we're going to throw in the show, that there's no sexual orientation. So if a guy wants to go out with a guy, he can go out with a guy. A girl wants to go out with a girl, vice versa, or however it happens. Or maybe one guy will go out with one guy, and then he'll go out with another girl, and then, I don't know, it'll just be crazy madness. So the only way we're really going to find out is by watching the show.
What's up?